It wouldn't be too expensive to test everyone frequently. It won't be cheap. But right now, the U.S. economy, for example, is losing trillions of dollars. We're spending trillions of dollars in stimulus. To test every single person in the United States every day for a year would cost only a small fraction of the most recent COVID stimulus package. And I don't even think we need to be testing every single person every day. We need to be testing a large fraction of people where cases are most abundant. And so that's why I think 20, 30, 40 million tests every day would be probably more than sufficient to get tests out to the bulk of the communities and really suppress the virus. And that would be an extremely cost-effective way. What it means, if we can really suppress this virus before vaccines become available, means the economy can open up again. It means we can actually start getting our lives back to normal. We're not going to have a vaccine tomorrow. We might not even have a transmission blocking vaccine next year. We don't know how well these vaccines are going to stop community spread. They might make people safer, which is good. But we also don't know that necessarily at this point. And so right now we have essentially at our disposal social distancing, mask wearing, and economic shutdown. Economic shutdown, of course, being an extreme example of social distancing. And we are seeing that there are pockets of this community in this country that are not willing to necessarily do those religiously, if you will. And so this is our next best tool. But I actually believe that this can be a better tool. This is something that can truly give people very rapid knowledge of their transmission status and sever transmission chains, bring the effective reproductive number of this virus down way below one, and ultimately suppress the virus in the community level. And so this would work alongside social distancing and mask wearing where it is occurring, and the unfortunate places where it's just not occurring, then at least this is something that people can do in the privacy of their own home and make decisions without whatever peer pressure, for example, might be leading them to not want to wear a mask and not social distance. So I think that the cost of setting up the manufacturing and doing this, it will be truly fractions of what we're currently losing. And it's not an overreach by any stretch to think that this is going to be too expensive.